What's up, guys? Robin Campbell here from thedancedojo.com, where we help you become a better social dancer. If you're tuning in for the first time, you are watching Finding the Beat, our free online series. It is progressive, so if you want to understand what's going on in this video, make sure you watch the previous videos. All the links are in the video description below, and hit the subscribe button to get all the updates. Let's go. Okay, so let's get into another song here. Remember, the goal of this exercise is to find the beat and tap to the tempo in the music. Once you can do that, use the phrasing, the musical patterns and sentences you hear to find the one. Once you can do that, turn off this video, get rid of the visual aid, and see if you can do it by yourself. If you can consistently tap to the beat and find the one at different parts of the song by yourself, that's an excellent sign that you're really picking up this skill.
All right, here we go, here we go. We're back with another song. This time it's Luther Vandross, Never Too Much. Love this one. Okay, so take a listen, see if you can find the beat, see if you can find the one. Were you able to find it? Sorry, I was having a good time there. So let's take a listen again, because this is a perfect example of how so many things we just talked about come together, and they really, really build and emphasize the one. So everything kind of builds up during the eight counts and comes back to that one. So let's take a listen again. So the first things that you're hearing are that snare drum on the 2, 4, the 6, and the 8, and that kind of funky guitar riff, and the piano. So the piano is very clearly marking the one. The guitar riff is kind of playing and having fun and building up, and then kind of fades out. And then that piano comes in again, hits the one. You also hear, like I said, the percussion. Specifically, that snare is really strong on the 2, 4, 6, and the 8. And if someone naturally asks you, like, hey, clap on the song or clap to the song, when you clap, you probably didn't know this, but you are clapping to the 2, the 4, the 6, and the 8. So now that you know that, you can clap to any song, and when you do it, you're going to clap 2, 4, 6, 8, and 1, and that's how you can find the one as well. When you mix it with the other sounds you're hearing that are phrasing an 8 and are melodic and build towards that 8 to help you find the one. So let's listen one more time. You're going to hear his voice drop in on the one as well, and as he's singing, it's very clear he's building towards the 8, and everything resets on the one again. I can't fool myself, I don't want nobody else to ever love me. You are my shining star, my guiding light, my love fantasy. There's not a minute, hour, day, or night that I don't love you. You're at the top of my list, cause I'm always thinking of you. I still remember in the days when I was scared to touch you, how I spent my day dreaming, planning how to say I love you. You must have known that I had feelings deep enough to swim in. That's when you opened up your heart and you told me to come and go, my love. So that's a pretty clear, shining example of how all this stuff comes together. Funk and soul music really, really appreciates, respects, and hits that one. So listen to that music as well. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else to say about that. I think that one was really clear, and it's going to help you. So now what we're doing with all these songs is, maybe this is easy for you, maybe it isn't, depending on your level, your experience, how much you listen to music, because exposure to something has a huge impact, is a huge factor
on your understanding of it. So the more you listen to music, the more consistently you listen to music, the faster you're going to be able to start hearing these patterns, recognizing these rhythms, these melodies, the phrasing, whether it's 8 beats, 16, 32, the more it's going to come to life in your mind, in your brain, the more you're going to feel it, the more you're going to hear it, the more you're going to recognize it. So expose yourself to more music. At the beginning, if you can't count music, exposing yourself to all sorts of popular music like this really helps. And then again, as soon as you get into salsa music, you just have to expose yourself to more and more music, because I couldn't tell the difference between a bachata song, a salsa song, and a merengue song when I first started listening to them. They all sounded the same. But then after listening to them, nobody has to tell you the difference. You start to hear the difference. So listen to more music. It's going to help you a ton. Keep it up.